Hey everybody, so I am making this video as a way to provide for you some information about changes that have occurred to your class. These changes can all be located in the syllabus, which I've already uploaded to Canvas. You'll see that it's called a revised syllabus for online. And all of the changes that have been made can be identified in there. And I've tried to help you identify where those changes have been made by highlighting the material in red. But generally speaking, you should be able to get everything in there. But I did want to provide for you just a sort of face-to-face kind of description here of some of those changes. As many of you are already aware, the class schedule, and by the way, I'm going to be referring to my notes here on my other computer. The class schedule for March 17th and 19th, that was obviously canceled, which at the time that I'm making this video, that would have actually been last week. So hopefully you were aware of the fact that classes were canceled. This week, you are currently on spring break. So I hope that you're enjoying that. But then next week as well, which would be March 30th through April 5th, that period of classes has also been canceled, and we will resume courses in an online format starting on April 6th, which according to the schedule should be week 13 of class. So because we had some classes get canceled, I obviously had to collapse some content. I actually had to get rid of a couple of assignments and adjust some assignments so that we could meet online, but also get the content in. So what we have done so far is all of your material is going to be put online. And this shouldn't be too dramatic for you guys, obviously, because a lot of the content was already done online. All your quizzes were done online. All of your assignments were submitted online, except for the reading questions. Those, of course, will now be submitted online, obviously. And so that's not going to be too terribly different for you. The part that's going to be different for you, of course, is going to be the delivery of the content. And so what I will do each and every Monday by 7 a.m. is I am going to upload and make available content that you will then use to complete your assignments, get information so that you can pass your quizzes, all that stuff. So when you go into your Canvas homepage, you will see that there are a number of tabs. One of those is called modules. At this point, or up to this point, we haven't had anything in there because I gave you everything that you needed. But now what you will do is every Monday by 7 a.m. is I will make a series of things available to you in modules. Generally, every week, I will provide for you a mini lecture that I have already created. I will give you your reading assignments. Again, that's still coming out of your textbook, The American Yap. And I will provide for you an upload to the lecture that I would have presented to you in class so that you can at least see this is what we would have covered in class. And then I'm also providing for you supplemental videos. Now, obviously, for those of you who know, which would be all of you, you'll note that I've got links in my PowerPoints which connect to videos. So you can click on those, watch those, and I've also provided for you these supplemental videos. So each week you'll have your reading assignment, which you're already used to doing. You'll have the PowerPoint lecture, which you're already used to doing, except at this point you'll just read through it. And that will be accompanied with a short mini lecture from me, which is about 15 to 20 minutes long. And then you'll have these supplemental films. The only week where you will not have any lecture from me, at least the ones that I was going to show in class, is for the Civil War. And the reason for that is because we were going to spend a lot of time on the Civil War, and I don't have just one PowerPoint. I have four or five different PowerPoints. And so what you'll get for that week is the mini lecture from me, your reading assignments, and then I'm just giving you a bunch of films that will broadly cover what I plan to look at during the class itself. But if you would like to have those lectures, you can, okay? Now, that's broadly what your thing's gonna look like, your class is gonna look like online. One of the things that I've become accustomed with over the last couple days is Zoom. And so one of the things I'm still working on and planning out, but I hope to have office hours where we can meet through Zoom. And I'll probably do that for about a half hour once or twice a week. once I figure that out, I will send an announcement out to you to let you know. But that way you can at least have one-on-one face-to-face communication with me if you choose to do so. That's not required. You can always contact me through Canvas Messenger, email, or you can meet with me during those office hours once I figure out that whole process. But other than that, everything else will be asynchronous and you'll be able to work at your own pace. Now, obviously, there's going to have been some changes to your due dates and assignments. One of the assignments that was completely eliminated was the in-class activity. Obviously, since we're not going to be meeting in class, we will not be doing that. So that particular assignment was deleted and done away with. Another assignment that was done away with was your online Civil War activity. And the reason for that is because the company that was supplying the online activity has deleted that activity. And for the life of me, I cannot locate it or find it. And so that got done away with. One of the things I'm doing to sort of make up for that is providing an extra credit assignment. And I think that comes during week 14. Let me take a look here so we can actually see here. Let me get into your modules page. But I've supplied you with an extra credit assignment where hopefully you'll be able to make up some points if you need them. And that will come during week 14, and the description is all there for you. To find out what your new due dates are, obviously you can look in the syllabus, but I think the fastest way and the helpful thing for me is just to go to your homepage. And of course, on that homepage, you can see all your assignments listed. For example, I know one of the assignments that was to be due, and I think it was initially supposed to be due on March 17th. I had a lot of questions about this. I think it was the primary source assignment. Where you were going to be looking at voting rights among white men and African-American men. That assignment was initially due on March 17th. That assignment has now been moved to April 19th. And again, you can see that reflected in your syllabus. One of the other major changes, of course, is that your assignments will now all be due. For the most part, they will all be due by 11:59 p.m., as opposed to when class would have been held in the face-to-face course. So you now have till 11:59 p.m. So please get yourself acquainted with the syllabus so that you're aware of some of these changes. A couple of other things I just want to make mention of. When it comes to the section quizzes, you have three section quizzes left to take. And one of the changes, of course, is going to be when those section quizzes will be made available to you. As it states here in the syllabus, section quizzes 4 through 5 will be made available to you on Fridays at 12 a.m., midnight, right? And the sixth section quiz, which is the very last thing that you will do, will be made available to you on Monday of the very last week of this class, which will be week 19, which is May 18th. And the due date for that final quiz is also changed. So just get acquainted with that. One thing I do want to stress here is that there has been a slight addition of an assignment. Obviously, I got rid of a couple of assignments, but I needed to sort of make up this assignment elsewhere. And because we are doing this asynchronously, for the most part, I have to ensure that you each week are going through the content. And so one of the things I'm doing is I'm adding a small little thing for you to do that you will submit with your 5 multiple choice questions. So I'm going to read to you the directions for this assignment, some of which you've already been doing. The next part we're adding. So it states here, reading questions and what I'm now calling content summary. It says, for homework, students will compose 5 multiple choice questions based upon the information from the online textbook called The American Yap. These questions should be multiple choice and they should draw only from the material in the chapters. Your questions must reflect content from the various sections assigned, and you must provide a reference, right? That is, you know, chapter whatever, section whatever, paragraph whatever. That's not new. You've been doing that. The only difference to this is now you're going to submit that online. Here's the new stuff. It says you will also need to write a 1-page summary of all the lecture material so as to demonstrate that you have looked through the content. And again, all of that material will be made available to you on Monday by 7 a.m. This material will be located in modules. The one-page summary will be worth up to 20 points. Now remember, the multiple choice questions were worth 10 points. This one-page summary is going to be worth up to 20 points. Therefore, the whole assignment will now be collectively worth 30 points. It says, this summary is not to be graded too strictly. It is only intended to demonstrate that you have looked over the material. Now, you're free to write more than one page. And in fact, I'm going to be providing you enough information to go well beyond one page. But I feel like one page should be enough for you to reflect some of what we've been covering, at least the broad ideas. And so basically what you're going to do is when you submit your five multiple choice questions, you'll have that on one or two pages. And then in addition to that, you'll also submit this one page summary. And again, please note, I'm not going to be going through those with a fine tooth comb. I really just want to make sure that you are going through the reading, referencing it in your one page summary, going through some of the lecture and film materials so that I know that you're getting the material. This assignment, you might recall that your weekly reading questions were always due on Thursdays. That is going to continue to be the case here, except instead of making them due at 8 in the morning, they will be due at 11:59 p.m. In fact, these reading questions and content summary are the only assignment you will have, which will not be due on a Sunday. So again, these assignments will be due Thursday by 11:59 p.m., which means you'll have 4 days to cover all of the content, right? Which normally we only met for 2 days. You're actually getting 2 additional days to go through this material. So if you have questions on that, let me know, contact me. And again, if we get a chance to do office hours, which I'm really hoping to do, then, we can talk through that stuff as well. I think everything else is pretty well spelled out in the syllabus. So go ahead and check that out. And if you have questions, you can contact me. Otherwise, I think that's it. And if any other changes are made to, this whole thing between now and when we start up again, I'll let you know. But for now, I think we're pretty settled in what we're doing. So that's it. So I will leave you as I always have left you with go in peace, be warm and filled. May the force be with you. Live long and prosper, and may the odds forever be in your favor. Have a blessed week, everybody.